Last week, I gave Democrats credit because they came out swinging on net neutrality, and it's very rare that they actually do what we want them to do. But in that instance, they did a really good job. You had Democrats in the House and the Senate unified on this issue of net neutrality, all vying to fully restore net neutrality. But now I'm going to have to take some credit back because there are two Democrats who are showing their willingness to opt for a half measure and essentially water down their phenomenal bill. So as Carl Bode of Motherboard Vice reports, during Tuesday hearings on the proposal in the House Communications Subcommittee, some Democrats, like Florida Representative Darren Soto, stated the bill was simply an opening offer and that Democrats would be open to amendments for the bill. Others, like Oregon Representative Kurt Schrader, insisted that additional compromise would be needed to ensure passage. Normally, compromise is a healthy part of the legislative process, but activists at consumer groups like Fight for the Future told Motherboard that at this juncture in the net neutrality fight, they're only likely to weaken the popular proposal. It was frustrating to hear Representative Soto say he's open to amendments on the Save the Internet Act, Fight for the Future's Josh Tabish told Motherboard. Given that his office was one of the bill's original co-sponsors, it's hard to view this as anything other than foreshadowing for a backdoor effort to water down the bill or add ISP-approved loopholes. Soto's office did not respond to a request seeking comment on what changes he'd offer. The problem, as activists see it, the FCC's 2015 rules took years, countless hearings, and several court battles to craft. The rules were rebuilt after the FCC's 2010 rules were struck down by the courts. They're the culmination of endless congressional debates over the better part of two decades. In short, the FCC rules were already a compromise, activists say. And that's exactly the problem. And I wouldn't really be sounding the alarm right now if it was just any Democrat, but one of the co-sponsors is saying we're open to amendments. Now, is an amendment inherently bad? No, not necessarily, because I think that if they can improve the bill and include bans on zero ratings, that would be phenomenal. But I'm not expecting that to happen, because if history is right again here, well, when you look at the California debate, there were numerous attempts to water it down. Numerous attempts. And finally, what was passed was a very solid proposal to restore net neutrality. However, anytime there were amendments, it was almost always not for the better. It was for the worse. So by opening the door to amendments and at this early stage already kind of waving the white flag in a way, this is opening them up to ISP-approved loopholes, as the article states, because ISPs are doing everything. They're working overtime to make sure that they defeat this and they maintain the status quo that Ajit Pai just crafted in 2017 when he repealed net neutrality. So it's not like, oh, well, we're going to open up amendments for, you know, maybe some Democrats to try to improve it. No, what's going to happen is you're opening it up to be watered down. And it's troubling, man. But I like that organizations like Fight for the Future, they are not taking no for an answer. And they're already crowdfunding a campaign to put up billboards to kind of shame Democrats like Kyrsten Sinema, who have not gotten on board. And what you're seeing on screen now is a mock-up essentially saying that she's corrupt. And I think that this really is the right approach. You can't really expect many Republicans to do the right thing. So I think our best bet is to put a lot of pressure on Democrats. So I'm going to give you the numbers to the two Democrats who are vocalizing their willingness to compromise. The first is Kurt Schrader. His phone number is 503-557-1324. And Darren Soto's number is 202-225-9889. I would recommend that you call Darren Soto since he's one of the co-sponsors, but I'm going to call Kurt Schrader because he is a representative in my state of Oregon, so I just think that that's more appropriate. So again, that's 503-557-1324. Oops. 1324.
Office of Congressman Kurt Schrader, this is John.
Hi, my name is Mike Figueredo, and I'm a constituent of Representative Schrader, and I just read an article from Vice that Kurt Schrader was essentially opening the door up to compromise on the Save the Internet Act, which is a really strong net neutrality bill, and I just wanted to call to urge him to not allow any sort of watering down or compromise, because I think this legislation is really fantastic, and unless it's going to be improved, then it doesn't need to be watered down. So I just really wanted to emphasize that Kurt Schrader should not compromise at all.
Okay, for sure. I can definitely pass that along to him, sir.
Excellent.
Can I get your name and your phone number, please?
Yes, my name is...
Excuse me, your name and your physical address is what I meant.
Yes, my name is Mike Figueredo, and my address is...
All right, I got your message. Thanks for calling, and I will pass that on to Kurt for you.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, of course. Bye.
Bye. Okay, and it's as simple as that. I don't feel the need to browbeat them just yet because, you know, they haven't officially said that they're going to water it down. But if we can kind of just nudge them in the right direction, I think that will serve us well because we've seen what happens when they open these bills up. They get worse because you have one of these shills for Comcast or Verizon and AT&T just get in there and they try to ruin it. We've just got to basically let them know that they need to do the right thing. And if we kind of take the pressure off for a second, this type of stuff happens. So don't water it down. I hope that since leadership like Chuck Schumer and Nancy Pelosi is on board, they fight to stop this bill from being watered down. But you have to expect the worst from Democrats and hope for the best because this is kind of just par for the course. So don't let them water it down. Pay very close attention because, you know, it's only a matter of time before ISPs try to chip away at this bill because this would be a huge step in the right direction.
You could support the Humanist Report at patreon.com/humanistreport. But trust me, I'd have way more supporters on Patreon if that was my podcast. Sad.